the heck is this thing? Something just doesn't seem right here. It's not green. All right, so we're on Hannah's farm and we're about to go make big square fodder bales. Now, the only red tractor this old I've ever driven was an old 1586. So there's a learning curve with us here. Gonna move the drone. You can sit like that. There you go. Yeah, honestly. Okay, so it's an 18 speed. Why are you grinding? Why are you grinding? That's better.
This is scary.
This is scary. I mean, I have full confidence in myself.
When it comes to green tractors.
How hard could it be? Let her rip. So right now we got about half a tank of fuel. We're gonna burn half of that getting there. Fixing the window she broke last night.
Got washers.
Washers.
I brought 3 and I'm probably gonna be glad.
Want me to do something or no, I'll just let you suffer?
What?
Nothing. Is it the right size?
Yeah, I wish it wasn't this one though.
Yeah. Here.
I got this.
Okay. Okay.
Maybe.
Shoot. I mean, I could probably get a bigger turn on it, you know.
That beautiful Magnum.
Oh yeah, right. So this is my ride today. Hannah's gonna finish raking while I square bale corn fodder. So never run a Krone BigPack 890 XC, but today we're gonna find out how.
Ha ha! I fixed it.
You got her? Good. Once the hydraulics warm up, go a little faster.
Have our head.
So now I am finally in this Case International 7220 large square baling for the first time ever. And I just got started up. It's so far really simple. I've been driving anywhere between 3 to 3.5 miles an hour depending on how much material is on the ground. So Hannah's down below me raking it up, and yeah, so far it's running pretty good. If I go a little bit too fast, it tends to overload the pickup. She just nodded. Pretty interesting. I just got started and I've already got about 20 bales out. So what I'm doing is making these for Hannah's family. This is their farm, and I decided, you know, she's been coming out and helping us enough. I figured I'd come out and help them for a day. Give them an extra hand. So this is actually, it seems like it'd be complicated, but it's actually, once you get going, it's pretty simple. I think the setup is probably the hardest part of all of it. So we're trying to run the PTO speed right around 1,020, and it'll periodically dip down I know you guys can't hardly see it because the refresh rate is the same as the camera's frame rate, but there it just nodded. So the difference is between round bales and square bales. So square bales are actually an older concept than round bales. Back in the old days, and you still see it like the Amish do it, are stacks of hay or fodder or whatever. And round bales were a newer concept a couple decades ago. And the concept behind them were that they're just simpler to handle. Now, you can fit more material into a round bale. However, typically square bales are going to be more dense, because when you're making round bales, what you're doing is pretty much using the round bale's weight to compress the material. Whereas with a square bale, it's got a plunger that plunges against the material and compacts it. But some of the other benefits behind square bales are that you can fit more material into a tighter space when storing it. So if you got a shed or something like that, you can stack it more full of material than you could with round bales, because round bales really don't like to stack all that nicely. With square bales, though, however, you can pretty much fill any kind of space full. One big downside to square bales, though, are that by themselves, they really don't keep outside, because when you get rain, the rain will just seep right into the bales and ruin them. Whereas with round bales, that'll still happen, but since the bales are curved on top, the rain will have more of a tendency to deflect off the bale rather than seep down into it. We're up to about 50 bales now. Everything seems to be running smoothly. So on our three SCVs, just nodded. On our three SCVs, on number three is to control the knives. Now, the knives aren't in, so that isn't a factor. The monitor will freak out if you have him pushed in, because right now the knives aren't in, so it'll start freaking out. So that's on number three. I've had to keep pulling it back. I don't know if it's just settling or what, but the monitor freaks out every now and then. It hasn't bothered in probably about 20 minutes now, which is nice. But number two is the pickup. So if I'm going through a ditch or anything like that, I can pick the pickup up. Whoa, say that 10 times fast. This baler actually has a steerable axle, but it's not hooked up right now. So I really don't hope that I do need it. So that's not even hooked up right now. But this field does have some hillier spots, one of which I'm about to go on right now. This tractor's handling the baler pretty well. I was a little bit concerned, but she doesn't seem to be struggling at all. Now that we've got about 50 bales, I'm gonna have to check the twine. Looks like we're getting low on the top set. That one's still full. That one's full yet. So I'll run a few more out and I'll take those out, move the bottom bales of twine up to the top, and then when they bring back new rolls, we'll tie them in down on the bottom and just keep it going. So the other side's good. There's a set of twine on each side. So close it back up. Keep on rolling. So this complicated system that you're looking at are the knotters. And whoever designed these deserves a medal, because they are complicated. But I'll leave the camera up on them so you guys can see how they cut the twine and knot it up, and pretty much just keep knotting each bale. And they have to be working properly, or else the bales won't be tight. Broke that one, so I'm gonna let it rip. Looks like we're missing a twine on this one. You can see twine, 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 no twine. No twine. So my actual problem is that there's a bunch of twine wrapped around the knotter down in there. It warms my heart knowing that in recent years they haven't improved knotting technology. Still the same as always. So now you see I routed the twine back down right through there, and then I gotta run it underneath here. Now from this point, I'm not totally sure what I gotta do. This is my first time, so.
No matter how tight it is?
No, because it's gonna break it. Okay. Up here at the end of the day. That's how we used to do them on the old ones, so.
Yeah. Let's give it a shot. I'm pretty confident it'll work now. Let's see. Here we got the pickup. It's right in there. Now there's a flywheel on the end of the PTO just in front of the baler up here. So that big round black thing, that's the flywheel, and its purpose is to maintain the pickup speed and to keep the plunger moving when the tractor starts pulling down, because it can cause chaos for the baler if you don't maintain a consistent speed. So they have those flywheels on there that are pretty much just a giant weight that keep the PTO turning until the tractor can keep up. All right, so Andy and I just spent like the last hour trying to figure out the knotters in the back of this baler, and we got it running again. So we broke a knot and just kicked out another bale, and we were trying to figure out how that was routed up from the bottom. We couldn't find a diagram or the operator's manual. But essentially, on the bottom, there are these four plungers that push the twine up on top to where it can be knotted. But right now I'm running about 3 miles an hour. I'm trying to take it nice and slow. Got pushed behind a little bit with the knotter issue, but I think now that I know exactly how this baler works and how everything's routed, I think if I have any more issues, I should be able to fix it relatively quickly. So, just kicked out another bale. But I got lunch for Hannah here, and me. I gotta find Hannah and take it to her. Looks like she's down there. Sun's going down and I only have about 120 bales. I've been having a lot of knotter issues. Basically, about every 20-30 minutes of running, I have to climb out and cut twine off of the knotters because it keeps getting caught up on that needle. All right, so a recurring problem that I keep having is that every time new twine, since we're going through the old rolls, goes through the knotters, it keeps messing me up. So looking over here, looks like the twine got caught, so I gotta re-thread it. And you guys may notice these little reflectors up here on top of the baler, and what those do are to let you know that there's no tension on the twine. So when they're up and the bar is across the reflectors, which I thought was like really dumb at first, because I'm like, why would they put a bar there? And then I realized that it's so like, if at night you need to, when the lights are reflecting back off the baler, that you can see that one is showing, and you can fix it. So I just gotta rerun this through. So far I've had it on three of these. I'm waiting for the fourth one to do it. So I've had issues now with all the knotters, but for the last 15 minutes or so, it's been running pretty smoothly. So I'm gonna keep on going and make as much as I can. The sun's going down, but I'm gonna still keep on rolling. Now the Krone actually has lights on it that you can control with the touchscreen up here. Oops. And it lights up by the flywheel and on top, which is really, really nice. Now this material is pretty wet, but they pretty much wanted to get it made. So they are calling for rain here tomorrow. So I want to make as much as I possibly can, or run as long as I possibly can, as long as the baler doesn't keep giving me issues. Cut the length down to 200 centimeters because they're hauling with their straight truck, and the bales were just a little bit too long, so we're shortening them up. Should be fitting better on the truck now. Okay, note to self, do not turn on the lights. Oh no. So this tractor has a bad cable that runs up into the cab, and without even thinking about it, I reached down and turned on the lights. They said not to turn on the lights. My question is, can I turn on some of the lights? Because that might be an issue once the sun goes down. And it It flat out killed the tractor. Like, no response, nothing. Just completely dead. That was a wake me up call. All right, let's test my theory since the sun's going down. Nope, you absolutely cannot turn on any lights. Uh-oh. What about these ones? I just said after I wiggle the cable again. Well, looks like this tractor doesn't have any workable lights on it. Well, in that case, I might have to borrow Hannah's Nemo and stick it out on the hood of the tractor. Gotta fire everything back up once again. Oh boy. Still doing it. Interesting. I thought I was packing the bales too tight, but I turned it way down and it's still messing with the knotters. So I gotta climb up and cut them off again. Ugh. This one on the right. All right. There. Okay. Just idle? Okay. Gosh, it's the chupacabra. Oh no, just a bale. What are you laughing at, Gumby?
You.
I think it was just bothering her a little bit too much that this bale was standing up on its side.
Ready?
Do your thing. How was the landing? Because you totally stuck it.
It wasn't as bad as I expected it to be.
So the Krone tech came out and he did a little work on the baler. So, I've been going back and forth thinking all day that it's been me that's been the issue with the baler, but it turns out that the thumbs that pull the knots off of the knotter and basically free them have not been making contact. He said that they're pretty far apart, and that was causing them to flip around instead of pushing them off. Cold?
No, I just...
Because I'm cold.
You're chilly?
I'm gonna lock you out!
Get out of fast radio.
All right, we're gonna keep bailing. We've got 400 total minus 196 is. I can't do math this late at night.
We're almost at 406, so we made 300 bales. Right? 96, 196, 206, 306. What? Okay, I'm doing this wrong.
196.
To 296. 396. So we made 208 bales.
Wow, you're so good at math.
I know, right? It's the third try.
That seems to have fixed the problem because we haven't had any issues with the baler since. So he's actually on his way back. He went back to grab some grease because the baler is like running dry. So you sure you don't want to bale?
I am good sitting here.
Sure?
I'm great.
Okay.
it again.
I don't know if he did. I don't think he did work to that one. Luckily, he should be on his way back to bring that grease. But I'm gonna have to fix this one. This has been the bane of my existence today. Okay, that one was actually not bad to get off. Now we're underneath the baler, and you can see the twine that goes in from the bottom. Now, one of these things is not like the others. That one should not be busted off and dragging along the baler. So, got to reroute it back up into these needles. These actually go up to the top, which at the end of a bale will send it up, this twine up to the knotters to be knotted. And then that's where it is, all the action's taking place. So, these rods here actually shoot up between the bales.
Green Acres is the place to be. Or something like that. Alright. Ouch.
The last 10 seconds were a good description of how today is going. On this, we can tie it off back here, and then it should handle itself. All right, we're gonna give her a shot. Well, we are all done. I was prepared to go until someone told me to stop, and someone just told me to stop. So we're gonna take all the tractors back and put them together and call her quits for tonight. So, thoughts on the 7220. It is an older model tractor, mid-90s. When I first got in it, you know, I hated it, but it's kind of grown on me. Not saying that I totally like it, but it's not the worst thing in the world. I mean, a tractor's a tractor. A lot of brand loyalty just goes that way. A lot of it's just, that's what we were raised with. So that's what we're familiar with. And I can see some of the designs on this thing that are just questionable, but I've also known John Deere to make a lot of questionable design choices as well. So, I mean, it has power. It can handle the, it can handle the baler. It's a good match for it. I think it would be good to have duals on this because on the hills that we're on, I got pushed by the baler several times. And actually, coming down the road when we were coming here, I hit the brakes and nothing happened, and it kind of scared me, but I had enough time to shift down through the gears and get my speed down so I could stop with the brakes, but that was a scary moment. But it ran good, other than the issue that we were having, like I mentioned before, it's a new baler, so those thumbs that pull those knots off, the knotters, weren't spaced right, and it just kept wrapping the knots up instead of kicking them off, and it kept pulling the knots out, and I'd have to get out repeatedly. But after the Krone tech came down and had a look at it, diagnosed it, he put a bunch of grease in the baler, it's been running like a dime ever since. So I know that the bales that it's been making are very dense. Andy was loading them up earlier, and he said that they were really dense. He said that you could feel the moisture on them, but he said that the bales themselves were actually dry. So, good material. We didn't get as much made as I was hoping. We got just over 350 bales made. I know I could have done a lot more than that if I hadn't had to keep stopping. But I like all the lights that are on the Krone. I really like that. I wish more implements had more lights. I think that that's often underlooked on a lot of equipment, and they have all the lights in just the right places. Oh, looks like this back window's open, huh? So today I ran around 3.5 miles an hour was my average. I tried running faster, but every time I kept trying to run faster, it kept plugging the pickup. And this thing's actually nice because if you kick the PTO out, it'll reverse and it'll unplug itself. So you don't have to get out and spend 5 minutes trying to unplug it. It's literally just as easy as shutting the PTO off and then turning it back on at the right time. So we just got up here to the tractors. We're gonna shut everything off and call her a day.